one and all. Right, okay, so just dropped the kids off and now I am heading off to the Malvern Hills, which is gonna be very exciting. And I'm gonna go and check out my LM62, my new Morgan Plus 4, which is partway through build. It should be pretty close to being finished now, actually. Should get it in the next couple of weeks. So I'm quite excited about this. So without any further ado, here we go. 4 hours driving. Whoop whoop. Away we are. Away we go. Okay, so the journey today is going to be a bit of a slog. So rather than the fun car, rather than taking the Yaris GR today, we're in the Porsche, the 992. A little bit of comfort and distance driving. So we've got M20, M25, M40. Then it'll be M5 and we're pretty much there after that. Don't know how long I'm going to be up there for before I then get back in the car and come back again. But essentially that is the journey we'll be doing. Right, so I'm going to hand you over to my time lapse, which is going to take us there because you don't need to see 4 hours sitting on motorways. And I'll fill you in with more detail when we get there. Right, okay, so first roundabout. I've already made a mistake. I should have gone up the M26, so I've added 10 minutes to my journey already. Well done, Julian. So I'm sliding onto the M25 now, and I'm following a rather nice new Audi e-tron. It's lovely. And immediately I am thinking, do you know what? I'm so glad I haven't got an electric car, because I wouldn't be able to do this journey in one trip, one charge. I could probably get there, but I wouldn't be able to get there and back in one go. So at some point I'd have to be stopping. In all honesty, I'm not up for doing much stopping on the journey. I want to get there, do the visit, get in the car and get back. I will need petrol. I've only got half a tank. But I didn't have any of that, must check the charging last night, must make sure the car's full for this morning. I just got in, I went, half a tank. I'll be filling that up on the way. But that cost me 5 minutes, maybe 10 at most. And then I'll get all the way back on whatever's left. Thank you. as a nation, we're pretty skint as it is, but I'd rather be skint like Spain and have decent roads. And that's it, and then we stop. Yeah, so joyous M25, just yeah, let's give you an idea of what we're stuck in, shall we? I'm not too sure. I don't know if I can just pivot that. No, I can't just pivot that round. Let's stick another camera view so you can see what we've got going on. Let's do this. Yeah, let's go M25. Oh, look, as soon as I pick the camera up, things are moving. I'm not one on the camera though, because that would be naughty. You gotta check out how noisy this is. 40 miles an hour. Sounds like I'm driving over potholes the whole time. Ooh. And back again. Wait for it. Smooth. And boom, 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 boom. That was horrific. I wouldn't mind. I've got to come back this way. I've got to do it all over again. But probably about 10 o'clock at night. It's a bit of a worry when you're pleased you're stuck in a traffic jam rather than driving, just because of the noise of the road. Whoever put this together, I hope you're very proud of yourself. Right, okay, so that's the M25 section done. So I'm not too sure what time to join the M25, but midway round it, I reset my clocks on the car and stuff just to see what we had. So I covered a distance from when I pressed the button, a distance of 40 miles. That took me 52 minutes and an average fuel usage of road noise. Average congestion of 37.9 miles per gallon. Not that we were doing any speed, but it goes to show, if you're plodding around a motorway in your Porsche, you can, you know, you're in your mid-30s. Yeah, but here we are, M40. Driving Standards Agency car, thank you very much, nice to see you there. Keeping people safe.
Okay, so
also getting ever closer to the Morgan Works Morgan factory. I'm so excited. So journey so far, nothing to report. Stopped at the work services. Nice guy came up and said, like, can't wait. Thank you very much. He's driving an XKR 4 litre, 1990, I think he said it was, something like that. Very, very quick to want to tell me. Lovely, lovely bit of kit. Supercharger. Goes like shit off a shovel. And if it's anything like my old man's convertible one, he probably spends a lot of money on it keeping it working. So that's it. I'm going to sign off until I get there, and then I might give you a little bit more gumph. Oh, seriously excited though. I might just get there and go, no, I'm not talking to anyone. I'm not going to be seen to be doing stuff on video. I just want to go and look at my car. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. Right, here we go. Here we are at Morgan. Already doing a little wee because we're excited. So they have got just a range of no LM62 to see yet, but I'm gonna get in there and have a look. And is that the CXT? Yeah, the off-roading CXT that I can't have because they're only making something like 3 or 4 of them, and they're about 250 grand. That's another reason. Anyway, that's it. Go ahead. This is awesome. Seriously, if you ever get a chance to come up and see what Morgan are doing, you really need to do it. It's people doing stuff and working hard. This is just one small part of the factory. So cool. Okay, so more Morgan stuff. So GTRs, look how lovely they are. So millions of pounds worth of vehicles set here. So £250,000 for one of those, all specced up nicely. I'll tell you what, it's pretty darn awesome though. Another CXT behind me in blue. I really wanted one of those, can't have one of those. This is a place to come and spend a lot of time. I could stay overnight and be here for days.
I'm smiling.
You're smiling. You're smiling. That's how excited I am.
It's when it's not levelling, he just walks away and says, I'll leave me to it.
It's when the screwdriver slips out of the head and it runs right across that bit of ash. That's the moment of truth.
That is my greatest fear when I do these.
Oh, flathead screws, they look so nice, but they're such a pain in the ass.
Oh, tell me about it. And I always try and get them level as well.
Nice, thank you very much. Well, I have no idea if this light's good enough for this recording, so I'm going to press on anyway and let's just see what happens. So, just on my way back from the Morgan factory. Oh my goodness, that was absolutely fantastic. The people at Morgan are so nice. It didn't matter who I was talking to, whether it be sales or guys in the factory, on the factory floor. Yeah, really proud of the work they do, and the work they do is really, really quite good. It's interesting, isn't it? You're essentially taking this combination of modern technology that sits inside the car, and actually you're wrapping it with. You're wrapping it with skill, ultimately. Watching what those guys are doing there, not only in terms of the ash frames and how beautifully they're made, but also what they're doing with the aluminium and everything else in terms of the bodywork and how they're moulding and shaping it. And I was watching a guy do the bonnet, two guys do the bonnet, put the louvres in, and they're doing it by eye. I mean, the guy's lining it up by eye on each of the presses. It's really interesting. And then you've got somebody actually forming the shape bespoke to that car. And it's just being done beautifully. I mean, it really is an art form and a craft that they're going through. So visit to Morgan. If you've got an opportunity to visit Morgan, you should visit Morgan. I mean, really, you should buy a Morgan and then visit Morgan, because it really is something quite special. Yeah. So thanks Dan, Marcus and the team. That was a fantastic day. I really do appreciate the time you spent with me. Yeah. Cheers.